Good evening, and I welcome you students for another amazing session on the carbohydrates family, which we were telling you about the various disaccharides, which we have discussed with you students, that disaccharides are formed when monosaccharides units join together through a glycosidic bond student. And this is a very important question. Glycosidic linkage student is very important. That means if I will discuss polysaccharides also, where there will be large number of monosaccharides joining together, how will they join students?
By glycosidic linkage.
Glycosidic linkage. Can you tell me what is glycosidic linkage students?
Sir, glycosidic linkage is the bond between is the oxide bond formed between two oxygen atoms by the loss of water molecule.
Between two oxygen atoms, make sure what you are talking, please. You take your time. I always say, student, take your time. You will not hurry up an answer. One line answer is there. You will write
between two monosaccharides through oxygen atom.
Okay. See, my point is, why do I ask these questions? We have been checking paper, student, for a long period of time. Students do very silly mistakes. They know it, but they write something wrong. Why? Because they are not writing very fast. Sometimes, students, you know the answer, but you don't write the correct answer. That is the problem will happen with large number. Student, make sure you take appropriate time for answering a question. And again, you see that your answer is correct or not, because questions are very objective, very specific. And one word, one line answer, or objective type, student, one choice. So if you tick mark, it's over. Therefore, make sure that you think before you answer. Think before you answer, student, pay attention. That is a whole game in competition. You know, in competition, all the answers will be so close to each other, they will all look correct. And therefore, we have to see what type of differences are there, student. What is involved sugar, students? This question was given in the paper.
Sir, in word sugar, sir, sucrose is known as invert sugar because the hydrolysis of sucrose brings about a change in the sign of rotation. It changes from dextrorotatory to levorotatory. And the product is known as the invert sugar.
Okay, students, question number 3 is coming before you. What are the two components of the sucrose, students? Or I could put then hydrolysis of sucrose produces which two monosaccharide, students?
Hydrolysis of sucrose produces alpha D glucose and beta D fructose.
That is the correct answer. And students, such questions will be there in the paper. Can you tell me, student, where is the glycosidic linkage in sucrose?
Glycosidic linkage in sucrose is at C1 of alpha D glucose and C2 of alpha beta D fructose.
Okay, correct answer. Can you tell me, students, what are the monosaccharides which make up maltose, student?
Maltose are alpha D glucose and alpha D glucose, two molecules of alpha D glucose.
Can you tell me whether maltose is a reducing or a non-reducing sugar, students? Very important question.
Sir, maltose is a reducing sugar.
Give me the reason.
Sir, because in maltose, the glycosidic linkage is at C1 of one alpha D glucose and C4 of the other glucose.
Excellent
so
answer.
One glucose molecule has one free CHO group.
Very good. Which is called the milk sugar, student?
Lactose.
What are the two monosaccharides which make up the lactose, students?
Lactose is made by beta D glucose and beta D galactose.
What is the relationship between beta D lactose and beta D glucose, students?
Both are epimers of each other.
Epimers. Which carbon? There is a difference in configuration.
C4.
Okay. What is the linkage? Where is the glycosidic linkage in lactose, students?
Glycosidic linkage is at C1 of beta D galactose and C4 of beta D glucose.
I thank you very much. All answers are correct. This is the type of questions will be there in the paper. It's up to the examiner how he gives these questions. Now you have a feeling of what you are doing. Do you feel you are learning something? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Are you feeling more confident? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Questions can be put in many forms, students. Reasoning, assertive, objective, but basic fundamental questions we are discussing with you. Our objective is you learn, student, learn everything. And by learning, you will be able to have a strong memory in your brain, student, by continuous recap, repetition, revision of what we are doing. And I want you should have a feeling of the subject which you are studying. Chemistry is science, students. That means we should understand it. Everything is a science, student. If we understand it, we will be giving a better performance. Everything. Here is a ginger tea, which I put a lot of ginger before I made a tea hot. There is a science behind this. When I start thinking, because I have to teach, I have to keep my throat proper. And you know, with corona virus threats, I have to keep warm my body, heated. It's cold, and as per my age, I may feel more cold than you. So I have to cover my body, student, thermostat, heating, and whatever we learn, student, from Ayurveda and other things. We do self-healing processes, natural diets, so that we can remain fit and healthy. So do I pray for you, students. The life is decided by all the things you do, students. You keep yourself healthy, keep yourself fit, then you will give a better performance, students. And then you eat right, think right, act right, students. Don't eat junk food, students, during the examinations. Keep things healthy and sleep well. Sleep well, I'm saying, is very important, students. Don't make yourself sleep starved, student. That is not going to help, because then our mind has a limit to which it can work. Your imagination is very essential, student. And in my webinar, your participation is must and 100%. And I will be learning also from you. So you are becoming my teacher, students. I am not a teacher anymore. And I always like children who are participating and who are working, student. If we are not working, what answers we will give? Tell me. And I want you to be prepared for everything. And every word we write should be known to us. Every word has a meaning. It speaks, and we should understand it. That is our objective. Decoding all the NCERT book is our objective, student. Tell me, till now, my teaching has been effective or not?
Yes, sir.
Do you think you have learned a lot of things from me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That is our purpose. So we were talking of saccharide sugar, students. And you are saying there are glycosidic linkages. Whenever polymers are formed, students, there has to be some linkage between the monomers. Somewhere bond will be formed, students. How it will be formed? Whether it is polysaccharides, it's protein or other molecules of DNA, RNA, whatever, nucleic acid, nucleotides, whatever we will study, student. So some bonding should be there. Some linkage will be there, what we call as glycosidic bonds or peptide bonds. And you have seen further hydrogen bonds or some type of attractive forces are there which are holding these particles together. Hydrogen bonding is very important, student. We have seen the effect of that. And also you will experience other types of attractive forces, ionic forces, dipole forces, van der Waal forces, everything is acting. Our attempt is to understand these forces, student, which are keeping these molecules together, holding them together, students. The atoms are forming, students, different type of compounds, and forces are there, bonds are there, which are holding these particles, and that's how the world is made, students. That is how the world is. This we have started understanding. Mainly, we are studying the biomolecules, the chemistry of the bio-living world, student, and they are made up of non-living molecules, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, all these elements are combined in a very, very complex way, student, to form very, very complex compounds. And we have been making attempts to know their structures, know their properties, and to study, student, the compositions, and to produce large number of these compounds for the benefit of the man. So the next thing which is on the screen, student, polysaccharides, they will contain large number of monosaccharide unit held together by glycosidic linkages.
Glycosidic linkage.
So easy it is becoming for you. Chemistry is like a play for you, student. These are most common and counted carbohydrates in nature, and they are acting as a food storage or structure materials. You are in bio, no more than me, so you will teach me some bio, okay. And starch, you see, you are using a lot of starch, student. There will be question on starch in the paper. It's very important question. So in starch is the main storage of polysaccharides of plants. Polysaccharides of the student, plants. Starch, okay. So students, starch, basically, when we study chemistry, what we are studying, that what are the components which make up the starch, student? First question, that what is starch? What is starch, student? Are you eating starch? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
What is starch you are eating? Tell me.
Rice, potato,
cereal,
lot of starch.
Vegetables, student, you are eating that. Then, from chemistry point of view, what is a starch, student? What is a starch? Again, I'm saying it is a polymer. It means there will be large components of the monosaccharide units. Polymer of what, student? That is the question. Is the polymer of, student, alpha glucose. So there will be alpha glucose units, students, inside this. Whatever starch you are eating, they are producing large amounts of alpha glucose, students. And there are two components. How many components? Two components, students, in the starch. Number one, polymer. Number two, there are two components. What are the two components? Then they will ask you a question. Name the components of the starch. One is called amylose, student. First time these names are difficult because we experience them for the first time. Second is called, student, amylopectin. Amylopectin. And then question will be that what are the differences between the two? So many times they have asked you, amylose and amylopectin, students. Try to see that if there is some structural difference, that is very important for us in the paper. Structural difference, students. Somewhere, some linkage is different. And you will see this amylose is water soluble, students. This is water soluble component and is 15 to 20% in the starch. How much is that? 15 to 20%. And chemically, student, it is an unbranched chain. I am saying unbranched chain. Got the point? Tell me.
Yes,
what
sir.
Unbranched. It is a straight chain?
Straight chain.
Straight chain. There is no side chain. Nothing side is coming out. How many glucose? 200 to 1000 students, alpha D plus glucose units. 200 to 1000. So you see that how much is the number, students? 200 to 1000 alpha D plus glucose units. How many? Can you tell me, students, how many number I'm telling?
200 to 1000.
Okay. Is that small number, students?
No, sir.
So you can see such a large number of monosaccharide units are going to combine through a linkage. Which linkage will be there, students, in this? What
glycosidic linkage?
Glycosidics. I'm so glad that you are understanding so clearly now, and it is becoming easy. The linkage is, students, glycosidic linkage is there. Okay. So students, chemically, amylose is a long unbranched chain with 200 to 1000 units. And students, the next question I always ask to you, you are aware, you are becoming our teacher. Students, where is the linkage, glycosidic linkage? Where is the glycosidic linkage, students? Tell me, which carbon will be the glycosidic linkage? C1 and C4.
And then C4.
Because student, it is all alpha D plus glucose. One will be,
yes sir,
at C1, other is at C4, the linkage takes place. So you have noted down these points, student. These are,
yes sir,
any line can be a question in the paper, 100% I am telling you. The students who are with me, they will get all answers, all questions, student, in the paper. We are fully prepared for any question answers. We will be doing each and every question which will be asked in the paper, students. So those who note down each and every of my line, listen to me carefully, or later on also you are getting recorded videos so that you can listen to me as a revision. Did you listen to those name reactions which I have sent to you, students?
Yes, sir.
You have to prepare notes, students.
Yes, sir.
And note down the mechanism of the reaction. They will be very important for competitions and others. The next is amylo. This is soluble in water. That means it is insoluble in water. Lot of things, student. When we study, we can answer a lot of questions. That is soluble, it is insoluble. Then it is a 15%. What is left then? 85%.
85%.
Is an unbranched. I said unbranched. It must be branched, student. See the life becoming easy. Branch chain, students. 1, 2, 3. Next time coming to the fourth point, student. So if you are able to understand, you are master of the subject. I wish I was given a coach of games. I understand the basic things now, how the coaches are helping those topmost players. Mm-hmm. Because they, once they know the technique, technical and practice, then they will be able to play, because they know where next round will come and they are anticipating everything. So unbranched, branched, students. And further difference would be there in some type of linkage, because it is a two linkage, student. There is a straight and there's a branching, straight and branching. Therefore, they will ask you at which carbon is the straight chain, student, unit. There will be a unit, student. And then there will be a branching. So in alpha D glucose units, chain is formed by C1 and C4. Same?
Yes, sir.
But side chain will be there. What will be the side chain, student? Between C1 and C6, students. Again, how the linkage is taking place in monosaccharide, students?
All glycosidic.
All right. So we understand now. Glycosidic linkages are important questions for the peer. They will be asked somewhere, glycosidic. So many times they have asked you, what is glycosidic linkage? Students, okay. Let us see the actual structures, which we don't have to draw in the paper. But to show you, students, these are given in the books. They can ask the Haworth structure of glucose. I told you. They can ask the Haworth structure of fructose. You learned it?
Yes, sir.
They're not asking to draw the structures of the disaccharides or polysaccharide, students, because it's very long and complex. But they will ask you the linkage. See, this is our C1 and C4. C1 carbon and this point, student, what you see, C4. C1 and C4 linkage, this is the glycosidic linkage, glycosidic. This continues, student, this dashed line means, there, how many of this we have already told you, how many are forming the chain, student, how many? the chain will continue, student?
200 to 1000.
200 to 1000 molecules will be there, student, of the glucose, which type of linkage. So the Haber structure is important because that glucose will be everywhere, fructose, glucose, or these sugars will be there in DNA, RNA also, students. Okay, when we will study advanced biochemistry, then we will learn all this more. From chemistry point of view, we are doing more than what we need, student. Now this is our amylose and amylopectin. What I told you, the linkage is important. Glycosidic linkage. What I say? Glycosidic linkage is at C1 and C4. C1 and C4, student. Here, this is unbranched chain.
Yes, sir.
Unbranched chain, students. Straight. What is happening here, students? You can see this dash line. Mean this will continue. This will continue. This is a one chain. This is also another chain, student. Continue. But then in between you have what you have? You have a unbranched chain, student. And then there is a branched chain linked to it. So instead of unbranched, I would say there is a chain, student, long chain, and then there is a branch chain. Okay. Now the chain which is there, they are linked at C1 and C4. Where is the linkage of the branched, student? See the C1 and C6. These are branch chain linkage. These are important questions. Important question, student. Where is the linkage is an important question for us. So this is the story of the starch. Any doubt here, students?
No, sir.
I have discussed all the questions which are possible. Any line, any word is a question. I always tell you, there is a so many possibilities. They are not going to ask you to draw it, students. So don't be worried about that. But what questions we give you, they are 100% any of these questions in the paper, students. Okay. Question could be framed in any form. Next, I am talking of cellulose, students. Cellulose. Now, cellulose, what is cellulose, student? You know, in plants, okay, the most organic substance in plant kingdom, what is that? What the plants?
Cellulose.
Okay. And it is a predominant constituent of cell wall of the plants. I'm saying cell wall of plant cell, students. Cell wall of plant cells is all about cellulose, students. Okay. And it is a straight chain polysaccharide. Straight chain, students. Certain words are important. Be noted down. It is a straight chain polysaccharide, students. What else you see here, student? And it is composed of, what is it is composed of? What is the composition, student? It is made from beta D glucose units. There will be beta D glucose units. What was the composition in starch? Which glucose was there in starch? Tell me. Which form of the
in starch? Alpha D glucose.
Alpha D. See the question now. If they say then starch, you have alpha D glucose, beta D glucose, or he will put two more choices. All the answer will look right because glucose will be there. But I said ki everything you have to be very, very careful, student, where the students will do mistake. There are differences. How much difference? One word difference is there, and that will be a question in the paper. Okay, all right. So we have to pay attention, students. And where is the glycosidic linkage, student? Where is the glycosidic linkage? Where is the glycosidic linkage?
C1 and C4.
Here, The linkage is between C1 and C4. One glucose unit, beta D, and other C4. C1 and C4, student, glycosidic. You are seeing that C1, C4 linkage is quite favorite. 1 and 4 is quite favorite, student, in many of these disaccharides and polysaccharides. It is coming. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
There must be a reason behind everything I'm telling you. What do you think? What reason is there? Whenever something is happening by nature, the more stable situations will be there. The molecules or the particles will try to pack up to become more stable, lower energy, students. If there are some repulsive forces, some repulsion, some steric crowding or some other problem, then you will see that this will become difficult, students, and such things will be difficult. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, students, we have to learn chemistry as science subject. Tell me, cellulose, you understood very clearly, students, cellulose?
Yes, sir.
One,
yes, sir.
Mark question, one word questions are there. We have to be very, very careful, student. Glycosidic linkage is the key for the formation of such large units of polysaccharides. More stable, lower energy states are likely to be formed, students. More stable, lower energy states. Clear? So we should learn all this, students.
Yes, sir.
Okay, students, further we go. Glycogen. You see the glycogen? Where do you see glycogen, student? Do you know where glycogen is present? You are a bio student.
Glycogen, it is a storage polysaccharide in humans.
In the animal body, student, carbohydrates are stored. Yep. You are saying carbohydrates are stored in the animal body, student, as a glycogen, student. Glycogen. Why do you need to store, students? Why do you need to store? When you are not taking any food for some time, what happens? Emergency. Then body will take it from where?
This stored glycogen will be utilized.
This is also called, student, this is also called, number one point, animal starch. Animal starch, student. That means it has some relation with the starch.
Yes, sir.
It has a something similar structure to starch. Okay? Because its structure is similar to, third point, structure is similar to, student, amylopectin. Structure is similar to amylopectin. And more highly branched, students. Therefore, its structure is more complex than the starch which we have shown, student.
Yes, sir.
And where it is present in the body, student? Where it is present, tell me.
Question. In muscles, in liver.
Liver. And muscles. Liver. And where is that pen going, student? Liver, muscles. There it is present in the liver, muscles. Okay.
And yes, sir.
Brain, student. And when, what it is, how it works, student? when body needs glucose, student, athletes, players or other ones, student, you have not eaten food for many hours, then what happens? The body will need student glucose, body will need energy student, and then glycogen student, there will be enzymes, they will break down glycogen into glucose students. So it is also found in yeast and fungi. Also found, where it is found, student, also in yeast and fungi, student. So this is the importance of glycogen. As I said, every word, every line can be a question in the paper, student. Therefore, we must learn each and every word, each and every line very clearly. So, I think the story of carbohydrates is quite clear to us now. What is the importance of carbohydrates, student? Carbohydrates. How important they are, tell me. How important they are for us. They are essential for student, plants and animals. Are they essential? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
And through food you are taking, you are aware of one important instant source of energy. What is that instant source of energy, student? You know about honey? Honey, you know, you use a lot, yes, students. In the system of medicine also, they are storage molecules. Carbohydrates are storage molecules, students. See, the molecules are doing, chemistry is doing everything. As starch in plants and glycogen in animals. Starch in plants. Plants are storing starch and glycogen is being stored in animals, student. Animals. And tell me, the cell wall of plants is made up of what, student? The cell wall of bacteria and plants, it is made up of what? You know, question was there, the cell wall of bacteria and plant, they are made up of, what is that? Which carbohydrate is that? Cellulose, students. Cellulose. And what else you are using cellulose for, student? You are, student, it is being used in the form of wood, you know. Furniture. You are making furniture, students.
Okay.
See that all the molecules of the chemistry, polymers, are of great use, students. And the cloths, students, you are making cotton cloth, students, fiber, cotton fiber. So they provide raw material for industries. Raw materials. Important questions are asked nowadays on raw materials for industry, student, paper industries. How the paper is being made, student? And they are saying that we should go paperless because they're made from trees and plants, students. And lacquers and brewery, student. And students, the 2-aldopentoses. 2 एल्डोपेंटोजिस स्टूडेंट्स, टू एल्डोपेंटोजिस ठीक है आर प्रेजेंट इन न्यूक्लिक एसिड. कैन यू नेम दिस टू विच आर प्रेजेंट इन न्यूक्लिक एसिड स्टूडेंट्स?
न्यूक्लिक एसिड में होता है 2-डीऑक्सी-डीराइबोज एंड डीराइबोज.
डी राइबोज एंड
टू डी ऑक्सी डी राइबोज.
इंपॉर्टेंट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टूडेंट. डी ऑक्सी, टू डी ऑक्सी डी राइबोज, डीएनए एंड आर एन ए, डीएनए एंड आर एन ए. डी ऑक्सी, डी ऑक्सी, दिस इज डी, दिस इज डी, बट डी ऑक्सी. सो यू नो द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस स्टूडेंट्स, दे आर एल्डोपेंटोसिस. Aldo means there will be aldehyde group. Pentoses mean five carbons will be there. Rest will be OH group. Students, you know about it. Aldopentoses. Aldohexoses. Aldo. Glucose is aldohexose. Fructose is a ketohexose. Ketohexose. ठीक है. Pentoses, saccharides which have how many carbons? Five carbons. Is it clear, students, what we have told you?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
All right. He says, glucose or sucrose are soluble in water, but cyclohexane or benzene are insoluble in water. Explain. Question, student. What is your answer, student?
Glucose or sucrose are soluble in water, but cyclohexane or benzene are insoluble.
They are six membered ring compounds. Both are six membered ring compounds, students. Six membered ring compounds. They are six membered ring compounds. You have 1 minute to answer the question, students.
In glucose and sucrose, OH groups are present which can form hydrogen bonds with water.
Okay.
Hence, they are soluble.
They are polyhydroxy aldehydes or ketones, students. So they can form intermolecular hydrogen bonds with H2
water molecules.
Okay, this is correct answer. One mark is given to you, students. What are the expected products of hydrolysis of lactose, students?
Hydrolysis of lactose gives beta D glucose and beta D galactose.
Important, very important question for the paper. Very important, because this has been asked many times, student. Lactose, student, what it gives?
Beta D glucose and beta D galactose.
Glucose and beta D. Glucose changed into galactose, students. You get 1 mark for this. Okay. Last question, student, on the screen.
How do you explain the absence of aldehyde group in the pentose acetate of D-glucose? The pentacetate of D-glucose does not contain a free CHO group because the pentacetate of D-glucose does not react with hydroxyl amine to give the oxime.
That is not the answer of this. He is already saying that the CHO group is absent, student. He is saying that this group is absent. Explain. If it is absent, that test will not be given. That we know. think about it. I told you the question answer is specific, and you people know about it.
Due to the cyclic hemiacetal structure,
that is the question.
OH
cyclic group. Because glucose exists in cyclic form, student. Because C1CHO of glucose and C5 carbon of glucose, OH of glucose, they form cyclic rings. They form cyclic rings. Therefore, he is saying it is not free. So we have to explain why, where it is gone. Where it is gone? It is still in the glucose. So it is because of the, where is the cyclization? Student, which carbons? Which carbon were forming a cyclic to form six membered?
C5.
Six membered. Okay?
Yes.
But what do you call this as?
This is called as furan.
Hemiacetal formation?
Achha. Yes, sir. Cyclic hemiacetal structure.
Cyclic hemiacetal formation. But I am trying to say, answers are known to you, but we have to be careful. Only one mark is given. If I write something else and it is not acceptable, you will lose marks unnecessarily. The answer was known to you.
Okay.
The key is provided to the those who are taking the papers, and only one word or one line answer is there. If that word is not there, no, zero. If that word is there or line is there, you will get marks. So it doesn't matter, you can't write anything you want. You have to know what is the demand of the question, and then only answers will be given, students. Okay, so far so good, students. Next, we are coming to students. Amino acids. We have discussed the carbohydrate, student, in detail. You know about them. Carbohydrates, we have discussed.
Yes.
Now we are coming to another biomolecule, which is called the protein. What are proteins? They are polymers of alpha amino acid. Proteins are also large molecules, student, biomolecules we are discussing. They are polymers of amino acids, students. And here I have mentioned the word alpha. Alpha amino acids. Theek hai?
Okay, sir.
The first question will be, student, proteins are the biomolecules, and you know how important they are, student. For a living system, are they important for the living system? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
How much protein we are taking, student, every day? You need proteins. What proteins are present? Where they are present? Can you tell me, students? Every part of your body, student, it has protein. And for the fundamental, student, fundamental basis of structure and functions of life. Structure and functions of life, student. What is the source of proteins in your food? Where you are getting, what you are eating for protein? Tell me.
Pulses, cereals,
milk, cheese, meat, fish, they all have protein, students. They are required for growth and maintenance of the body. Growth and मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द बॉडी, दे आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द ग्रोथ एंड मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द बॉडी. प्रोटीन इज डिराइव फ्रॉम प्रोटीओज, ठीक है, प्राइमरी और अ प्राइम इंपॉर्टेंस. And all proteins are polymers of alpha amino acids. Alpha amino acid students. That means student, at least there will be one NH2 and one COH. There will be at least one and one carboxylic acid. This is my carboxylic acid. There will be at least one NH2 and one COH group present in them. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, what do you mean by alpha students? Alpha. See, this is my carboxylic acid. This is my carbon. This is my carbon. This is my carbon. Like this, it can continue. ठीक है?
Okay. Okay.
This is a carboxylic acid. You know, is given number one student in IUPAC. This is a very priority wise functional group. Is at the number one position. This carbon is called alpha, beta, gamma, delta, and so on. So, which is the alpha carbon student? Next to, this is my CO. Next carbon to COH is called alpha carbon student, alpha carbon. So, alpha amino acids were obtained, students, when proteins were hydrolyzed. They subjected proteins to hydrolysis. And what they obtained? I am saying hydrolysis of proteins was done, students. And what they obtained on hydrolysis of proteins, students? Alpha amino acids. That means these are polymers of alpha amino acids. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, there has to be NH2 group attached to this alpha position, student. This alpha position, NH2 should be there. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
If I put H here, student, then this becomes my R. It could be anything. I have not defined yet R. It can have more than one NH2 group. It can have more than one COH group. It can have other linkages, sulfur or other things could be there. So this. If I fix these students, so I could put it like this: RCH, NH2COH. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
और in better terms, we are very careful. Okay, I write it like this, students. So this is my alpha carbon. Alpha carbon. So this is R is my side chain, student. Like this, I can keep on changing the R and produce amino acids, a large number of amino acids, which exist in nature. But what we, our interest will be, student, because we are going to talk about protein, students. So we will be talking of alpha amino acids. Alpha amino acid students. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So students, I am talking of now natural amino acids. Because amino acids can be prepared also, synthetic also. Lot of organic chemistry, synthetic chemistry now. Man makes it. The natural amino acids, I am showing it like this, students. This is my COOH, NH2H, and this is my R group, student. This is my R group. Okay? So,
yes.
Their names are, you can see, trivial names. What names? You have a table in the book, actually. Let me tell you. You have a table in the book. I have taken only a part of that table. Such a table will be there in all the books. Just to know more about them. We have taken a part of the table, student. You can see the names are coming. Name of glycine, alanine, valine, leucine, isoleucine. This see. I am not talking of any IUPAC system here. Did I? These are not IUPAC names, student. These the natural amino acids I am talking, students. And actually, 20 natural amino acids are there, which have been shown in the tables in the book. And why say their names are trivial names? Trivial names, students. And alpha trivial sometimes reflect the property of that compound or source. Property or source, student. Glycine, it has been named because it is sweet in taste. This is glycine, student. If this becomes H, if I replace this by H, what will it become, student? COH, H, NH2H. This is my glycine, student. And this is sweet, actually, so the name was given. Glycine is a word, student, which means Greek, means sweet. Greek, glycine, Greek means sweet, student. And triacine was obtained from cheese, student, cheese. So that is that means sweet. Triacine, student, tyro means cheese, student. Amino acids are usually represented by three letters. Three-letter symbol, C, glycine, alanine, valine, leucine. Three-letter symbol, student. Three-letter. See the three-letter?
Yes, sir.
Names. Three letters have been used, students. And also, one-letter symbols have been used. Because you see, when large number of amino acids will be present, then we will use one letter. Large number will be there. Because we are going to form proteins, polymers, student, polymers. Polymers always contain large number of monosaccharide units. You know about it, yes? So one letter words have also been used to student. One letter symbol. Coding. Coding is being done now. You know, a lot of coding nowadays, students. So students, in the book of NCERT, you are given 20 natural amino acids, 20 natural amino acids. And these amino acids are actually optically active, which I have written here, except one. The question was, which is optically inactive? Which one is optically inactive? Which, whatever 20 amino acids have been, which is optically inactive, students? Which natural amino acid? This question was given. Can you tell me, students? You have 1 minute to answer the question.
Sir, glycine would be there. Glycine.
Glycine will be there?
Yes, sir.
So, answer is glycine. All others have asymmetric carbon.
Asymmetric carbon. All the four groups are different.
Asymmetric carbon, what they are? I am saying they are chiral. Glycine is
a chiral.
Glycine is a chiral. Therefore, it is optically inactive. Such questions are put student wherever they find. And most naturally occurring amino acids. I have shown this. Tell me, this is D or L? D or L, students, what do you think? How did I write? Now, in glyceraldehyde, I use OH.
Yes, sir.
When OH was on the right side, what was it?
D.
D. That was D plus glyceraldehyde. OH was on the left side. We called that
L.
Now here, that most of the naturally occurring are NH2 left, then what could we can say about them? They have
NH2 on left side.
Yes.
So OH will be on right, so they are D.
D?
NH2 on the left.
Most of the NH2 are on the left side student, therefore they will have L configuration.
Achha. L. Okay.
Questions are like that, one word, one line answer. Student, pay attention to everything. That is how the questions will be there in the paper, students. Therefore, students, most of the naturally occurring amino acids have L configuration and they are represented by writing like this, students. They will be, how did I write, student, like this. Why I showed this configuration, NH2 on the left side. And this is my R group. R is changing, student. R is changing. This is the side chain. R will change. What will happen? You will get other amino acids. And I'm saying NH2 on the left hand side. That means their configuration is L configuration. Clear?
Yes, sir.
R is the side chain that we are and getting different students, different amino acids will be by changing the R student, and therefore we can obtain these 20 natural. All right.
Okay.
In our next lecture, further. That is the chapter further on what are the proteins and their structures. Therefore,
okay,
I hope we have been able to answer many, every word, every line will become a question for people. Pay attention. Answer, you can get full marks in chemistry. I'm not
yes,
on anything. Every word, every line, I will decode. You mention, okay, this can be a question, students. In different forms, the questions will be there. Because you know the trend of objective type questions, assertive reasoning. They may ask directly. So we should be prepared for everything. And I thank you very much because you have been able to answer all the questions correctly. And continue, and I will see you.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Right. Take care, relax, and have a sound sleep in the night. Okay.
Bye. Yes, sir.
Bye.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.